It's so gloomy outside. Look at this. Ta-da! You cannot see the blue skies no more.
It's all white and fog.
I don't know if you can see that on camera, but it's all fog in person. And I used to really dislike when it rains, but now because it's so hot and I'm living in a glass house, I love the rain. The rain is actually very welcome these days. And I am here in my office. I haven't been here in a really long time. I'm here because I don't want to be noisy talking and Scotty's gonna wake up. He is a bit fussy today. Slater has him. Thank you, Slater, for taking care of him right now. And I'm in my home office. It's been a while since I've been here, as I mentioned, because I'm always outside in the living room with Scotty or in the room. And now look what Slater has done, because he's the one who's taken over my office. He has this monitor here, and it's not even because he's working from home, it's because he is a gamer from home. So he plays COD with his guy friends. So my desk, which used to be empty with a single laptop, is now filled with stuff. He has his monitor here and the PlayStation there on the floor. My station has been overtaken. While I'm here, I wanted to give you guys a little update on life lately. These are some things I listed down that I really did not expect to happen after pregnancy. So there are a lot, like there are things that people don't tell you and things that you will be surprised to realize after you give birth. And so I listed them down here on my phone. It's quite funny, actually, my friend Nicole Anderson, she's the one who told me to do a video on this because I keep texting her and saying like, oh my gosh, this is happening to me, this is happening to me. And she keeps laughing and saying like, oh my God, you need to tell people about this because these are things that nobody thinks about when they give birth. Like everybody thinks like, giving birth, you're always gonna be with a newborn that's cooing and is so cute, and you don't realize what's gonna happen to your body. You don't realize like all these little cute details that happen. And so that's what I'm gonna be talking about today. The first thing that I wanna tell you guys about, oh my God, chika session lang tayo today. Let me sit here. Ugh. The first thing that I'm gonna be talking to you guys about is baby grunting. It's so weird. Let me just find a cute angle so you guys can see me properly. So, you know how babies, like when you think of babies in your head, you always think that they're like cooing, like oh, like oh, like these cute little noises. But newborns, guys, they grunt. It's so weird. I don't know if it's just my newborn or newborns in general, but newborns grunt. It's so strange. Like for example, Scotty, when he is a little fussy or like he's trying to poop and he's on my boob, then he'll say things like rrr, rrr, and then he'll like try to find my boob and he's like rrr, rrr, rrr. I swear it's a grunting noise. It's so freaking weird, but at the same time it's so adorable. Like how can someone so small sound that old and angry? It's really funny, but I really expected more cooing. I think that's gonna come in the coming months. Right now it's just a lot of angry grunts from my baby. Another thing I did not expect is how fast babies grow. Like I know that babies grow really fast. Like they always say, don't invest in like newborn clothes, like newborn, like 0 month clothes, because in a few weeks, baby is going to overgrow them and then they're gonna be so useless, etc., etc. I did not expect it to be this fast. I don't know if it's just Scott or if it's like all babies in general. Scott is not yet even 2 months. Not yet even 2 months, but he is already wearing clothes for 6 to 9 months. That is insane. That is like, he totally skipped the 3 month sizing range. He just skipped from newborn range and then 6 months. It's so crazy. So now a lot of the things that we prepared for him for his 3 month to 6 month period, they don't fit him anymore. And all of the newborn clothes that I thankfully just borrowed from my best friend and my sister-in-laws, thankfully I didn't buy anything. So the clothes for newborn, he's outgrown already. So now we're at the 6 month mark. It's just crazy how fast, like we have this rocking chair. It's a lazy boy that rocks back and forth. And I used to nurse Scotty there, and you know he loves sleeping there, but now it's scary to put him there because he can easily kick from the armrest and then his head will come flying to the wall, which is so insane. Like in a span of ilang weeks lang, he grew out of that chair. It's so crazy. And now when I nurse him, he's so heavy on my arms. And the thing with Scotty is, he does not want to be put down at all. He wants to be on you the whole time he's sleeping, otherwise he wakes up. And so it's very painful for my arms. In fact, like my fingertips, you know the feeling when you like lie on it for too long or raise it for too long and there's no blood circulation on your hands? That's the feeling I have for the past week. Like it's all like ants all over my fingers, and I think it's because Scotty's so heavy and I'm always carrying him and he's always like squishing and cutting off my blood circulation. So that is also something that nobody ever told me. I did not expect that to happen. It's so weird. Okay, I had to rush out there for a little bit because I heard Scotty crying, but Sita says he has it under control. So let us continue with the things I did not expect. Recovery, let's talk about recovery. I did not expect my postpartum recovery to be so fast. In fact, I don't remember recovering at all. I'm sure it was painful, but maybe I'm just lucky, but I don't remember going through anything significantly horrible. Yes, I remember there were stitches down there. I definitely tore. I had a third degree tear. And there was something going on in my butt area. There was something going on in my stitches area. But I think about after a week or two, definitely more than a week, maybe 2 weeks to 3 weeks, it just completely healed by itself. I used the Tufts medicated cooling pads, which I talked about before, and they really helped a lot. And aside from that and all the like topical creams that my doctor told me to put on, I don't remember anything. And I do remember that labor was insanely painful and that I was shaking uncontrollably before I got my epidural. I remember it was so painful, but they say that there's this thing called mom amnesia. I like to call it as momnesia. And it's like once you have your baby in your arms and once like your whole world is overtaken by this new being, human being in front of you that you made, like you just forget all of these things that you went through, like all of these pregnancy symptoms, the discomfort, the actual labor pains, you just forget it, and then you just want to have a new kid. I mean, another kid. And I totally get it. Like, I don't remember every little detail like I thought I would. I thought it would be like so traumatizing, so scarring, and I always look at all these birth vlogs, birth stories, like tell-alls. I watch it so many times on YouTube, and I thought that it would be imprinted on my mind like a major experience. But all I remember currently is that yes, it was painful, but that's it. Like the pain passes, everything passes. All the 9 months of being pregnant and complaining, it's gone. And now I have Scotty and I'm so happy, and I would go through all of it again in a heartbeat. And I know that sounds so cheesy, but it's also so true. So yeah, that's something I didn't expect at all, but it's something really cool. And I hope not in the near future, not in the near future definitely, but years and years and years to come, Sater and I will have another baby. Okay, another thing that I did not expect, which is so weird, is how my boobs have become so lopsided. I'm gonna cover them. It's so weird, especially in the first week when my milk just came in. I think my milk came in at about 3 or 4 days after I gave birth. That's when I felt really engorged and they were so painful. And you know, I had engorgement and I had to like take a hot shower and put hot compress all over my boobs, and I had to hand express my boobs because they were just rock hard. But I realized that the girls have become lopsided. Like one boob, my left boob, had become significantly bigger than my right boob. And it's not because I only nursed Scotty on my left boob, which some moms have asked me. It's not that at all, because I latched Scotty on both boobs. I'm sure he has a preference. I think he prefers my left boob, so he probably sucks on the left boob more than the right boob. And that's why the right boob is significantly smaller than the left. Although recently, it's not as bad, the lopsidedness, but I swear, like maybe 2 weeks in, it was so clear. Like, you know when you brush your teeth and you're leaning forward on the sink, and usually like I don't wear any clothes because I just came out of the shower and I brush my teeth before I like wear my clothes and everything, and I can see from the mirror that like if these are my boobs, like this is the left boob and this is the right boob, like that's how much of a difference there is. Like if this is the sink, like the counter, it's like that. And it's so weird. And Slater always tells me like, oh, I can't really tell. You know, guys, they don't really notice anything. But I felt so weird, and so I researched and did my best to find out like what the remedies are for that. And apparently they say just keep latching baby on the slacker boob. There's a term, it's called a slacker boob, and usually people who have this issue, it's usually the left boob that produces more. I also have so many moms who came up to me and said, oh my god, Chris, I'm the exact same, my left boob is also the like the star of the show, and the right boob is the slacker boob. And so just don't forget about your slacker boob, mamas, because the more you let your baby latch on the good boob, and if you forget your slacker boob, then the smaller and smaller it's going to become, and the difference is going to be more pronounced, and you're going to be more uncomfortable. And so just, even though it's hard, like for example, Scott in the beginning did not want to take my right boob at all. I think it's the different nipple shape and everything. I just forced it and tried my best to let him latch on my right boob, even though it was so obvious that he preferred the left. And now he actually prefers the right boob more than the left, strangely. And so I think that helped a lot. I still feel a little lopsided, but definitely not as crazy as it was in the first few weeks. And I was also in contact with a staff member or the owner of the distributor of Haka Philippines. That's so weird, but Haka Philippines is the brand of my catcher, the milk catcher. I always post about it on Instagram. So it's like when Scotty's latching, direct latching on my one boob, the other boob will kind of drip milk everywhere. And so you squeeze that silicone bottle thing and place it on your boob, and it's supposed to catch all the things that are gonna drip down anyways. And because there's a little section, it kind of like allows the milk that's around the area to just squirt out. And so I'm so lucky because I have a lot of let down milk, and that is the only way that I've been getting milk for my stash, which now has over like 100 plus bags. I'm so lucky because Scott's not even 2 months yet and I have 100 bags already, and I don't even pump. So I'm very, very happy about that. But the Haka girl told me all about the slacker boob and the good boob. And she said, when you're not doing anything, just put the Haka or the slacker boob, and then the good boob, just catch them. Like, don't squeeze it, don't suction the left boob, but the bad boob, suction it. And then even if nothing comes out at first, just keep doing it, keep doing it, keep doing it. And then it will eventually like produce milk, because your body will think that there's a baby who wants to get the milk from that boob. And so your body will produce more milk there because it's like supply and demand. And I will talk about this more when I do like a how to get your milk supply up and stuff like that kind of video, because you guys have requested it a lot. But yeah, I didn't really do that, her suggestion, but prior to her telling me that, when I would direct latch Scotty on my good boob, I wouldn't haka my other boob because I thought there's no milk anyway there. Like, it's whatever I try to haka it, like nothing falls, no, like zero letdown at all. And she told me, no, just always haka it even if there's no letdown, because eventually your body will learn to produce letdown on that side. And so that's what I did, and now it collects about 1 ounce every time I nurse Scotty, which is every 2 hours, which is pretty good. From zero like to 1 ounce, that's the average. The good boob collects like on average 3 ounces, and on good days 5 ounces. Sometimes it's 3.5, sometimes it's 4. So it, just keep at it, and if you don't stop and don't give up on your boobs, then they will keep producing milk, because again, it's a law of supply and demand. Speaking of boobs, I did not expect my first few weeks to be like an Amazonian lady here in my home. I'm always boobs out. Everything hurts when you're breastfeeding, so your nipples are so sore. You can't even wear a bra because the cloth of your bra will really hurt your nipples. Even when air, like there's a breeze that passes by, your nipples are so painful. Everything hurts. And so the only thing that will allow your nipples to breathe is, for me at least, to put those like nipple creams and then let it air dry. So I was always out and about in my glass house, good thing I don't have neighbors, topless, like completely topless for weeks. And that really helped me. I was fortunate enough that my nipples did not crack, did not bleed. They were dry, but the nipple butter really helped a lot. I used the one by Earth Mama, and so that was really amazing, an amazing experience. It wasn't good, but it was very memorable. Sometimes now my boobs still hurt when Scotty latches like really hard on them, or sometimes when I use the Haka for too long, then it does really hurt as well. So then I will air dry it. Slater usually comes into the room really late at night because he plays online games with his friends. And so when he enters the room and I'm already sleeping, it's usually like me topless, like, ugh, I look so weird. And honestly, I did not expect that at all. I remember when I see mom friends or my sister or, you know, different moms that are breastfeeding and they're just so openly like showing their boobs to everyone. Not just showing their boobs, but they're like feeding their children in front of me without like a nursing cover. And I thought to myself, wow, these moms are so brave and they're so confident with their bodies and they don't care. They don't care when if somebody like a stranger, not really a stranger, but they don't care when they're seen by other people, like their nipples are seen. And I thought to myself, like, I would never be like that. Like, I'm sure if somebody visits us, I'm always gonna have a nursing cover. I'm sure I'm gonna be so shy. I'm sure like some bahay at home are never gonna see my nipples. Oh my God, I did not expect that. Now I do not care because it hurts so bad and all I want to do is have Scotty latch on me correctly. I don't want him to sweat. I don't want to sweat. I don't want to think about anything else. I just want to feed him. And because I'm so tired, like I just want everything to be convenient for me. And so, yeah, I do not expect myself to be showing my nipples or even talking to you guys about nipples here on my YouTube channel. And on Instagram, I do not expect to be like parading my milk, but you know what? It's effort to collect milk. It's 80% of my day, and I'm so proud that I'm able to feed my son. I'm so proud that I'm able to collect a stash for him. So I will post about it because, you know, I'm a mom now. I'm a cool mom. Next thing that I did not expect is that zero sleep to mean actually zero sleep. I thought when they said, okay, sleep as much as you can now that you're pregnant because when you get a baby, you're not gonna be able to sleep at all. I thought that just meant like, ah yeah, your sleep's gonna be putol-putol, but I'm used to it anyway because when you're pregnant, you wake up every hour to pee or every 5 minutes to pee or every 30 minutes to pee, whatever. But no, because when you pee and you're pregnant, you just get up, you pee, you go back to your bed, you fall back asleep. But when you have a baby, you get up, you feed him, you can't sleep when you're feeding him because you have to hold him. And then even if I'm side lying, I can't sleep when Scotty's latching on me. And then I have to burp him, and then I have to change his diaper, and then I have to soothe him so he goes back to sleep. And there are all these things. And I swear, the first week, every night I just get like maximum 15 minutes of sleep. That was so crazy. And I didn't want to bother waking Slater up because why would I wake him up? Like, it's just, it's useless for two people to be awake for no reason. I might as well just do it myself. Slater has been so amazing though because in the day, like now, he's taking care of Scotty. He does give me a break when he sees that I'm super tired. He's amazing at soothing Scotty without the boobs, of course. So like when Scotty's being a little fussy, he knows exactly like how to dance him, how to carry him, to soothe him. And he is also the diaper changer when Scotty has a poopy because I don't want to go there. So Slater does that, which is really good and helpful. So I'm very thankful for Slater. I did not expect him to be like that as well because I don't know, I just didn't expect him to be so hands-on. But I guess it's also because we are in lockdown. Like Cebu is still in ECQ. I think we're in MECQ right now. I don't really know because I'm just at home. But I think that's also one of the reasons why Slater has been so hands-on because he has time to be at home now with us. Guys, I did not expect breastfeeding to be harder than actual labor, harder than the actual pregnancy. I did not expect breastfeeding to be the hardest part of this entire journey. They say that, you know, when you're pregnant, you have your first trimester, second trimester, third trimester, and when you give birth to your baby, the first 3 months are actually your fourth trimester. And I didn't believe that. I just didn't think it would be that bad, but honestly, it's the hardest trimester, the fourth trimester. Like, it's so hard. Breastfeeding is the hardest. I did not expect that. Because, you know, when you're pregnant, your baby is with you. You don't hear the crying. When you eat, your baby eats automatically. You don't have to think about poops or diapers or sleep. You just think about yourself. You're just uncomfortable. That's it. But you're a princess when you are pregnant because everybody's like, oh, let the pregnant lady sit down. Let the pregnant lady go first and stuff like that. But when you are in your fourth trimester or where I am right now with Scotty, like you have to think about all these things. Like there's another person who needs, he's so vulnerable, he can't do anything, he needs you for everything. And so there's no, absolutely no time for yourself, but I'm just lucky because Slater actually allows me to rest for a bit. So I was able to put on makeup today, I was able to do my hair today. Yeah, and Slater has Scotty today, so I'm able to talk to you guys today, which is amazing. Okay guys, I have a few more. Even if you're so tired, even if you're like, purely exhausted for some reason, you cannot just leave your baby with someone else. Like me, I keep checking on Scott even though I know Slater has him. Or when our night nurse comes in, I always check the CCTV. Like I know I trust her completely, but I just always want to see Scotty. And like if I don't see him for more than 2 hours, I miss him so much and then I go to his room. So it's useless. Like even if I could have sleep, I don't have sleep because I'm always thinking about Scotty and worrying about Scotty and all these things. It's so weird. Like, even if you're so sleep deprived, you just want to smell your baby and stare at your baby. Even though, like, your eyes just want to shut, but you just, even though you're so tired, you can't sleep because you just want to stare at your baby. It's weird. I did not expect that. Another weird thing I didn't expect is I didn't expect my toes to be so dexterous. That sounds weird, but when you are latching your baby is on you, you can't really like reach for stuff because you have to hold your baby, and then this arm can't really reach, right? And not everything is at arm's length. So my toes, I did not expect my toes to be so dexterous and to be able to reach to things and grab things for me. Like when I'm side lying and I'm latching Scotty on my boob, my toe will get my pillow from far away in my bed, and like I can have something in between my legs, stuff like that. Or like if I'm trying to get his burp cloth, if I'm trying to get something, my toes will do it for me, which is pretty cool. I did not expect that too. I did not expect I would be very sanitary, but you know, when you are alone and you're breastfeeding, it's the middle of the night, like you do what you do. I also did not expect myself to be eating like a pig and drinking like a pig. Not drinking alcohol, but drinking any liquid at all. Guys, I don't even like milk, but now I discovered this milk that I really like, and I have it like, I have 2 liters in 2 days. That's crazy, that's crazy. I'm not really a dairy fan, but for some reason, I'm just thirsty all the time. I have tea, I have milk, I have so much water, I have cacao, I have coffee, I have so much liquid, which is crazy. It's when you're breastfeeding, you get so thirsty, you can finish like so many liters of water in a day. So there's always like, you can finish all this, because whenever he tries to get for my water bottle at night, I'm like, hey, get your own. So you can finish all this. Yes, and then I need some more. Like at 5 a.m., 4 a.m., I wake up to refill my huge water bottle because it's gone. It's crazy how much I can drink, and it's crazy how much I can eat. I was talking about this in my previous vlog. I eat breakfast, I eat recess, I eat lunch, I eat recess, I eat dinner, and I have midnight snacks. That's 6 meals, and it's not even like little snacks like nuts or like chips or like a banana muffin. No, it's like meals, like a heavy sandwich, not even a salad. Like I eat so much, and I really think that's also one of the reasons why I have so much milk, maybe. Because I have so much food to give Scott, I'm like overproducing, overconsuming, and so I have so much food to share. I don't know, that's just my logic. But I'm eating a lot of soup, a lot of just meal, like heavy meals in general. And I did not expect that. And another thing I didn't expect is that even with that, I'm still losing weight. I'm eating so much, guys. It's not even funny. Like after every meal, ice cream, cookies, cake, I didn't expect it, and then I will still be losing weight slowly, very very slowly, but I am losing weight. It's so weird, and I don't even exercise yet because I don't have time to exercise. I've only probably moved like 2 or 3 times since I gave birth. That was 7 weeks ago, and I'm still losing weight, and I'm eating like a pig. So that's something I didn't expect, and I think it has a lot to do with breastfeeding, because after I breastfeed, that's when I get the most hungry, that's when I get the most thirsty. And last but not the least, this video has been really long already. I did not expect that too, but I did not expect that my life would be sitting down on a couch the whole day and then lying down on a bed the whole evening. I am so immobile. I did not expect that at all, but I did not expect that it would be so so rewarding as well. I did not know that I would be this cliche and clingy to my baby. I thought that I would be like a very, not hands off, but more lenient, more chill kind of mom. But honestly, like, I just want to be with Scotty all the time. And I just want to give him everything. And I'm just so happy when I see him and he's full from drinking milk, from direct latching on me. It makes me feel so contented. It makes me feel like I'm a complete person. I just want to provide for him. I just want to protect him. I just want to stare at his face. I don't know. I can't explain it, because a lot of you guys aren't even married yet or don't even have a family yet, or, you know, are very far from this journey. And I'm so appreciative that you guys are still watching all these tips for moms. But I really can't explain it. I really can't explain it. It's a different kind of love. It's like, yeah, I love my mom. I love my dad. I love my family. But when you have your own family, like when a person shoots out of your vagina and then you see your husband playing with this little thing and you're feeding this little thing and giving it life, and like, oh, it's just so beautiful. Even though it's so tiring, it's so rewarding. It's really a different kind of love. I'm sure if you are a mom and you're watching this, you can relate. I have so much appreciation for my mom now. I mean, I've always loved my mom, but we've always been so close. I've always been so thankful for her. But now, oh my God, grabe. Especially the breastfeeding moms, damn. Iba, iba talaga. I mean, if you don't breastfeed your kid, that's completely fine. You do you. I don't really judge people and kanya-kanyang journey lang yan. But what I'm saying now is, grabe. Iba, iba. Iba ang love ng mom. And I think if you're watching this, you should say, I love you and thank you to your mom right now, after this video, or right now, text them right now, because they deserve it, guys, and they would be so happy to hear that from you. If Scotty grows up and he tells me one day, like out of the blue, that, oh, hey mom, I love you, I miss you, I think I'm gonna cry. Anyway, guys, that is all the things that I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this little chatty sit-down sesh. I surely did. It's nice to be back. It's nice to be back in my home office and talk to you guys again. It's been a while. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please don't forget to leave me a thumbs up, comment down below, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next one. Bye! Mwah.